Hello and welcome to the geography class. In this video, I'll be continuing with chapter 4, that is agriculture of class 10th geography. We'll be discussing about the types of cropping seasons. In India, there are three cropping seasons, that is Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. So let's discuss them one by one. Rabi. Rabi crops are sown in winters between October to December and harvested between April to June. Some of the major crops of this season are wheat, barley, peas, gram and oilseeds. Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh are important producers of Rabi crops. So you need to remember that the Rabi crops are sown in winters. These are winter crops. Now, talking about Kharif crops, these crops are sown at the beginning of the monsoon and harvested after rain, that is between September to October. Kharif crops are also known as summer crops. Some of the major crops of this season are rice, maize, jowar, bajra, jute. Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar are important rice growing states. In Assam, West Bengal and Odisha, three crops of paddy are grown in a year. And these are called Us, Aman and Boro. Zaid, in between Rabi and Kharif crop, Zaid crops are grown. Some of the major crops of this season are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and fodder crops. Sugarcane is planted in this season but takes almost a year to grow. Now we'll discuss the major crops. A variety of food and non-food crops are grown in different parts of our country depending upon the variations in soil, climate and cultivation practices. These are categorized into different categories like rice, wheat, millets, maize, pulses. These comes under the grains category. Then sugarcane, oil seeds, tea, coffee, horticulture crops. These are food crops other than grains. Rubber, fiber crops, cotton, jute. These are non-food crops. India produces 50% major crops. Now, Rabi crops. We'll discuss these seasons in detail. Sown in winter from October to December and harvested in summer from April to June. Important crops are wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. States such as Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Western Uttar Pradesh are main Rabi crops producing states in India. Availability of precipitation during winter months due to the western temperate cyclones helps in the success of these crops. Means it requires the winter rainfall, which generally takes place in the northern region of India. It helps in the growth of these crops. The success of Green Revolution in Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan has also been an important factor in the growth of Rabi crops. Kharif crops. These are sown with the onset of monsoon in different parts of the country and harvested in September and October. Important crops are paddy, maize, jowar, bajra, tuwar, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soya bean. Some of the important rice growing regions are Assam, West Bengal, coastal regions of Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Maharashtra, particularly the Konkan coast along with the Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. So you need to remember that India is having a very good coastline. So the coastal regions are best suited for growing the Kharif crops. So the states like these states which I have mentioned just, these are good in producing Kharif crops. Recently, paddy has also become an important crop of Punjab and Haryana. In state like Assam, West Bengal or Odisha, three crops of paddy are grown in a year called Us, Aman and Boro. Now the Zaid crop. Zaid season is a short season between Rabi and Kharif season during the summer months. Crops produced are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and food fodder crops. Now you need to remember all the juicy fruits and vegetables are grown in the Zaid crop season. Now we'll discuss some of the major crops in India. So first is rice. It is a staple food crop of a majority of people in India. India is the second largest producer in the world after China. Kharif crop, which requires high temperature, that is above 25 degrees Celsius, and high humidity with annual rainfall above 100 centimeters. For growing rice, lots of water is required. Rainfall is required. Grown in the plains of north and northeastern India, coastal areas and the deltaic region. Development of the dense network of canal irrigation and tube wells have made it possible to grow rice in the areas of less rainfall such as Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan. Now in this map you can see the dark area marked here showing the major rice growing areas in India, that which includes a large part of the coastal region. Then the light area, light colored mark area, is a minor area where it is grown. Now wheat, second most important cereal crop. Main food crop in north and northwestern parts of the country. It requires cool growing season and bright sunshine at ripening time. It requires 50 to 75 centimeters of annual rainfall evenly distributed over the growing season. Important wheat growing zones, Ganga Satluj Plain and Black Soil region in Deccan. Major wheat producing states in India are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and parts of Madhya Pradesh. Here in the map you can see the dark area mark showing the major wheat producing areas in India, covering a large part of northern plains of India, and the light area is a minor area where the wheat is grown. Now talking about millets, jowar, bajra, ragi are important millets grown in India. Millets, many students, they don't understand millets. Millet is mota anaj. Though these are also known as coarse grains, they have high nutritional value. Ragi is rich in iron, calcium, other micronutrients and roughage. It is a crop of dry season and grows well on red, black, sandy, loamy and shallow soils. Karnataka is the largest producer followed by Tamil Nadu. Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand and Arunachal Pradesh are also important ragi producing states. Jowar is the third most important food crop with respect to area and production. It is a rain-fed crop grown in moist areas. Maharashtra is the largest producer of jowar, followed by Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Bajra grows well on sandy soil and shallow black soil. Rajasthan is the largest producer, followed by Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana. Maize, used as both food and fodder. Kharif crop, which requires temperature between 21 to 27 degrees Celsius and grows well in alluvial soil. In states like Bihar, it is grown as rabi crop also. Use of modern inputs like HYV seeds, fertilizers and irrigation have contributed to the increasing production of maize. Major maize producing states are Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Students, we are discussing these food crops in detail, reason being a large question comes on any one of the food crop in the paper. Means for example, question like what are the characteristics of growing the wheat in India, right? What are the climatic condition it required? So such question comes, so you need to remember all the points. Pulses. India is the largest producer as well as consumer of pulses in the world. These are the major sources of protein in a vegetarian diet. Major pulses grown in India are tuwar, urad, moong, masoor, peas and grams. These are different pulses or dals. Pulses need less moisture and survive even in dry conditions. All these crops except arhar helps in restoring soil fertility by fixing nitrogen from the air, because of which it is grown in rotation with other crops. Major pulse producing states in India are Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and Karnataka. Now we will discuss food crops other than grains: sugarcane, oil seeds, tea and coffee. Now first is sugarcane. It is a tropical as well as subtropical crop. It grows well in hot humid climate with a temperature of 21 to 27 degrees Celsius and an annual rainfall between 75 to 100 centimeters. It can be grown on variety of soils and needs manual labor from sowing to harvesting. India is the second largest producer after Brazil. Main source of sugar, jaggery, khandsari and molasses. Major sugar producing states are Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Punjab and Haryana. Now oil seeds. India in 2008 was the second largest producer of groundnuts in the world after China. Different oil seeds are grown, covering approximately 12% of the total cropped area of the country. Main oil seeds produced in India are groundnut, mustard, coconut, sesamum, soya bean, castor seeds, cotton seeds, linseed and sunflower. Groundnut is a kharif crop and accounts for about half of the major oil seeds produced in the country. Linseed and mustard are rabi crops. Sesamum is a kharif crop in north and rabi crop in south India. Castor seed is grown both as rabi and kharif crop. Tea plants grows well in tropical and subtropical climates, endowed with deep and fertile well-drained soil rich in humus and organic matter. Tea is a labor-intensive industry. It requires abundant, cheap and skilled labor. Major tea producing states are Assam, hills of Darjeeling and Jalpaiguri district in West Bengal, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. In 2008, India was the third largest producer of tea after China and Turkey. Tea cultivation is an example of plantation agriculture. Now we'll discuss about coffee. India produces about 4% of world's coffee. Indian coffee is known in the world for its good quality. The Arabica variety, initially brought from Yemen, is produced in India. This variety is of great demand in the world. Its cultivation was initially introduced on the Baba Budan Hills, and even today its cultivation is confined to the Nilgiri in Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So students, so far we have discussed some of the major food crops in India. We have discussed about the seasons, different seasons, that is Rabi, Kharif and Zaid, and we have discussed some of the crops which are non-food crops, right? So wait for the next video. We'll be discussing more about different variety of crops. Thank you for watching this video.